Hi everybody, Dr. Joe here. I wanted to take a moment and just connect with my community again and talk to you about GoLove 20. We've had over 70,000 people affected by GoLove 20. The numbers are probably way higher than that at this point. I told you the last time we spoke that there would be a mutation coming, and I want to talk to you about that mutation. I want you to think about elevated emotions for a minute. Think about the emotion of love. What happened when you felt love when you were spreading the GoLove 20? You notice that love inspires us. It inspires us to give. It inspires us to express. It inspires us to serve, to care for one another, to be kind to one another, to listen with compassion and understanding. And love actually causes us to create. We become creative in that state. And you've heard me say that when there is a change in energy, there's a change in your life. And an inspiration is a change in energy. And if you don't change your energy, if you stay in the same energy, then it makes sense that your life stays the same. So if you can become inspired and raise your energy, you become aware of things that you were once unaware of. Why? Because energy causes us to become conscious of things we were once unconscious to. In other words, you change your frequency, you have more access to information. And that's the name of the game here. So if you stay at the same level of energy every single day, then you will be unaware of possibilities. So you'll not be able to create anything new. So you can't see any possibilities again, from the same energy. In order for you to become inspired by love, inspired by energy, you'll become conscious of possibilities that you were once unconscious of. Now, energy or energy in motion, they are emotions. And so if we live by the same emotions every single day and we haven't changed who we are, and there's a movement happening, or you're in the creative state, and you stay in the same feelings and the same familiar emotions, then you can't see any possibilities because you're looking through the lens of some past experience, and you can only see the same. So then, inspiration then, the word inspiration means the movement of energy. Inspiration to inspire in spirit. It is becoming more energy and less matter. So the question is then, who inspires you? And what is it about them that inspires you on a personal level? What in your future can you become inspired about? And can you use certain people and certain things in your life to change your energy? And so we decided to create the mutation called You Inspire Me. And You Inspire Me is designed to do that exact thing. I want you, number one, to think of a person in your life that truly inspires you. Now, I just don't want you to think about them and leave it at that. I want you to think about the qualities and characteristics that this person demonstrates that you would like to become. And for me, I'm inspired by people who stand on the stage in our community, who explain their healing from start to finish. And to me, they are triumphant. They're a hero. People who, in the coherence healings, pull out all the stops and give as much love as they can to another person and get lost and consumed by that energy, I'm inspired by them. Watching people do the walking meditation with such sincerity, such passion. People, when I'm looking at a strip chart in the back of the room and we're measuring brain activity, and I see a person slip into an altered state and I know what's going on with them and I see what's happening to them, I get inspired that I want to have that experience. I want to have more of that. And I watch people do the breath, you know, and it's kind of interesting because some people who are inspired when they do the breath, the inspiration, the movement of energy, the music, everything, they become inspired and it becomes less mechanical. It becomes less of a technique. They're not trying to step by step make something happen. The inspiration, the movement of energy is already happening and their body already knows what to do in the process of moving energy. So those are my heroes. Those are people that inspire me. And when I sit down to do the work or I sit down to dream or create, I think of you. I think of our community and so many great souls that are actually embodying this work. So once you come up with that person, the next thing I want you to do is I want you to get very clear on the very specific things about them that you appreciate, that inspires you. And then just like Go Love 20, all I want you to do then is take a little time and I want you to close your eyes and the meditation will begin. And I want you, after contemplating what it is that you are inspired by about them, when the meditation starts and I ask you, what is it or who is it that inspires you? What is it that inspires you about them? I want you to use them to raise your energy so that you can begin to see possibilities that you never saw before and begin to create from a different level of energy. Now, once you do the meditation, we have a little logo that says, "You inspire me." And all I want you to do is send them that logo. Now, different than Go Love 20, you don't need to be affected in order to spread it. If you feel inspired by somebody, I want you to send them that logo, and I want you to use them to raise their energy. And if you want to send them a little note, a little video, a little audio, a little text about what in detail inspires you, you can do that because that'll help you express and move energy. It's not necessary, but if you do, it will help you to get into that state. So we will post the link right above the video with the meditation. I want you to get involved fully into it. And I think that if you can do this meditation and change your energy, and we have the entire community becoming inspired and raising their energy, we are going to see possibilities during this time that we never saw before, and hopefully we'll emerge more conscious and in a greater frequency and greater possibilities. I hope you enjoy it. You inspire me.